Abbey, dog. We the Baker Boys. And this is Russell Simmons, One World Music Beat. Huh. You heard? Get Abbey.
Don't touch the style, fool.
Hey, what's up? I'm Kimora Lee, and this is Russell Simmons, One World Music Beat. I'm chilling in Teaneck, New Jersey, outside the home of DMX. We are really far from the School Street Projects, wouldn't you say? We're waiting on him to come out. We're going to take a ride with him to his platinum party for It's Dark, Hell Is Hot, his first album, soon to be double platinum. But before he gets here, take a look at this little piece I want to show you. It'll tell you why everybody's screaming, "Where my dog's at?"
Where my dog's at?
If there was a defining characteristic to hip-hop in 1998, it was the jiggy factor, an aesthetic of unapologetic flash, cash, and glamour that ruled everything around us and made hip-hop even more relevant in this strange political climate. But of course, for every movement, inevitably there exists a counter-movement, and no one embodies this exhilarating energy more than rapper DMX, a gifted lyricist many compare to the late Tupac.
I always dreamt that I would make a big one. I never thought it would happen, but everybody dreamed about it. You know what I'm saying? Yo, I loved it. I wish that was me. I never thought it would happen. I was like, they would just never understand me. You know what I'm saying? Because I knew I was hot. I knew that wasn't the reason why they just didn't understand. I was like, the world must not be ready for me. You know what I'm saying?
As an adolescent in Yonkers, New York, DMX was naturally, almost instinctually drawn to hip-hop.
You know how it is in the hood, you either rap, you know, do the beatbox, dance, you gotta do something, because hip-hop, you know, it's a lifestyle, so you gotta fit in some type of way, you gotta fit in there somehow.
Well-versed in old-school history, DMX borrowed his stage name from a hip-hop artifact.
DMX is a beat machine. I used to beatbox. You know, took the name, kept the name, you know, because I was, like, still a beatbox when I was rhyming. When I first started writing rhymes, I was still a beatbox, so... Yeah, I thought beatboxing would never go out of style.
After a turbulent and isolated childhood, man's best friend also became DMX's.
I love pit bulls. Those are the only dogs that I have. I've had other dogs, but I mean, ain't no dog like a pit. You know what I'm saying? Their attitude. You know, their attitude is like, you might break both of my legs. You might break all of my legs, but I'm still gonna bite you. And I'm still gonna continue to try to bite you. As long as I can move, as long as I can breathe, I'm gonna try to finish you, money. You know what I'm saying? And then they mad loyal. You know what I'm saying? When I was growing up, I ain't had no friends. You know what I'm saying? But that my dog, and he was just like me. He was my only friend, I was his only friend. We needed each other. You know what I'm saying? We needed each other. I learned how to be a friend by having a dog. You know what I'm saying? A dog shows you how to be a friend for real.
Although his music delves into the deepest and most complex issues of Black America, at heart, DMX is a simple man.
You know, enjoying life, you know, doing things like this, playing with my dogs, getting old cars, hooking them up, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, being my family.
What's up, it's Kimora. I'm chilling in a limo here with DMX. How you doing?
Good.
We're on our way to Carbon to celebrate his platinum album, It's Dark and Hell Is Hot. And how do you feel about your album? How do you feel about the success of your album? It's platinum.
I love it.
Damn near double platinum.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. I'm enjoying the success. You know what I'm saying?
Tell us about your latest video.
One that's out or one I did?
The one you just did.
I did a video for the Belly soundtrack.
And who shot that?
Hype.
Hype Williams.
Yes.
Is he
going to
do all your videos? He's done three.
Well, I wouldn't strip myself to one person to do all my videos. You know?
Right.
But I'm going to work with him.
All right. I want you to take a look. We have some more stuff on Hype, some videos he's done, his latest work, Belly, and latest video that he's done for DMX. Take a look, Hype Williams.
Yeah, check it out.
To cast Belly, Hype chose to work with his favorite rappers, DMX, Nas, and Method Man.
The reason why I picked DMX to play the lead in this film was it had nothing to do with him being a rapper or him being a amazingly gifted writer. It had more to do with his ability to deliver.
I go through a massive transformation, you know what I'm saying, from a cat who thinks it's all about money, you know what I'm saying, and wants to chase the dollar, strictly the dollar, to an individual who understands what life is really about, and therefore changing my route. Ooh, and that rhymes.
And are you up for any more parts right now? Are you reading for any other parts?
Yeah, I got a few scripts. You know what I'm saying?
Really?
Yeah,
a few scripts?
I got like seven.
That's more than a few.
I ain't really, you know what I'm saying? But you know, I'm not gonna really get what I'm worth.
What are you worth?
I think a lot more than what I'm...
A couple million? Definitely, right?
Easily, at first.
We're going to keep talking about Belly, and if you'd like to come to New York and catch the Belly premiere...
The Belly premiere,
and hang out with DMX.
T-Boz, Terrell Hicks,
everybody else.
Method Man, my man's in there.
Check out what the big boys have to say. They're going to tell you how to do this.
All right.
It's Kamora again. I caught up with Irv Gotti, head of A&R Def Jam. How you doing, Irv?
Hey, what's up, Kamora?
Irv is responsible for signing DMX, the man behind DMX. Tell me about that.
That's my man. I've been with DMX for like 10 years. So as soon as when I got the nod and, you know, I started working at Def Jam, I signed him. He was the first thing I really wanted to sign. That and helping bring a Rockefeller over.
Is he difficult to work with, or how is he? We want to know.
X is, you was with him tonight. Look, X is... My
experience, I know, is different than yours on a daily basis. I've had enough today.
X is the best way to spend. And what I mean by that is just... Sometimes he's hard, sometimes he's easy, but X is a beautiful person, man. I love X. And once everybody that knows him, you're forced to love him because he's a good person. It's just that he has demons that he deals with sometimes.
I'm going to keep talking with Irv Gotti. I want you to check out this week's Hot Flick. It's Kamora again. I caught up with Onyx and the family. I'm chilling here with Sticky Fingers. What's up?
What's real?
Tell me what brings you out tonight.
My man DMX, you know what I'm saying? Today is platinum party, so we had to come show love, bottom line, you know what I mean?
And how do you feel about his album going platinum?
I feel like it's a damn shame his album went platinum. I don't think his album should have went platinum. I think it should have sold like 5 mil straight up. You know
All
what
right.
I'm saying?
I'm going to stay here with Onyx, talk to them a little more. I want to show you this piece on Missy Elliott and her protege, Nicole. Look who I found, Russell Simmons, CEO of Def Jam Records. What's up, Russ?
I'm all right. It's hot as hell in here, huh?
It's very hot, but it's a hot party.
Oh, man, I'm sweating like a slave, though.
Congratulations.
He got a double platinum.
That's true.
1.9. They say it's double platinum. They say it's platinum, but it's double platinum.
All right. And how do you feel about the... That's
what DMX has had. DMX is one of the greatest poets of all time. People don't realize it's certainly of our time. And what he's saying about our time, like the science that he's dropping and the poetry that he's writing is so important.
All right, well, there you have it from the man who definitely knows. I'm going to stay here and talk to Russ for a little while. I want you to check out the 411 with Pierre.
What's up? This is Pierre with the 411, 911, and Star 69 in hip-hop. Well, to end the summer with a big bang, Sean Puffy comes to a fat, fat, fat party in East Hampton, Long Island on Labor Day weekend. On hand for Puff's all-white gala affair were some of the biggest names in show business, including Heavy D, Penny Marshall, Andre Harrell, Quincy Jones, and even Titanic heartthrob Leonardo DiCaprio. Well, sources say partygoers sipped champagne and jammed to the music all night long until dawn. You hear me? Puffy's partying days may be over for a while. Well, the rapper and CEO is in training for his big screen debut this fall. He'll be shooting Oliver Stone's On Any Given Sunday, which also stars Al Pacino, LL Cool J, Bill Bellamy. Where's my name at? Somebody forget me? In other news, hip-hop mogul Russell Simmons says designer Ralph Lauren is biting his style. Yo, Ralph, don't bite my man like that. In an interview with the New York Post, Simmons accused the billion-dollar company of stealing one of his top designers, Matthew Parr. This after Lauren broke off talks of buying Simmons' Fat Farm clothing line. R. Kelly fans, pay attention. R. Kelly will drop a new double CD entitled R at the end of this month. With 14 hit singles in 4 years, including the Grammy Award-winning hit I Believe I Can Fly, R. Kelly is preparing 28 new cuts for R. The diverse album, which features everything from ballads to hip-hop to radio-friendly pop. All right, that's it. Now don't play yourself. Stay tuned to Russell Simmons' One World Music Beat.
What's up? It's Kamora. I'm still here chilling at Car carbon for DMX's platinum, soon to be double platinum party. I'm gonna go find some more people to talk to, and I'll be right back. Stay right there.
Well, this is Russell Simmons, One World Music Beat, and we'll be back.
Hey, it's the Baker Boys, Nick V in the spot. We back with Russell Simmons' One World Music Beat. My baby girl, come on, take it away.
What's up? It's Kamora. I'm having a great time at DMX's Platinum Party. I'm going to keep kicking it. I want you to take a look at this week's Top 5 with the Baker Boys. I'll be back.
Keep bringing us up. It's the Baker Boys, the hot videos of the week, Eric B.
Yeah, coming up at number 5, we got DMX. How it's going down.
How it's going down. How it is going down, Eric B. Get at me, dog. Soon to be platinum, double platinum album, yours. Def Jam once again. Get at me, dog.
1-2-1-2, we're back in effect. Russell Simmons, One World Music Beat. Let's go see what Kamora's doing right now. Come on.
I'm sitting here with Jadakiss of the Locks. How are you, Jadakiss?
I'm doing fine. How you doing?
I'm pretty good. How do you feel about DMX's platinum, soon to be double platinum success?
Yeah, it feels great. You know, the whole Rough Rider team, we all started from the bottom, and it feels great for...
be double platinum success.
Yeah, it feels great. You know, the whole Rough Rider team, we all started from the bottom, and it feels great for him to be going double platinum and for us to be almost double platinum. We thank God, you know what I'm saying? It's great.
And tell us about your connection to all of this, the family, the Rough Riders.
Yeah, you know, we all from Yonkers, New York. Y'all all probably know that. But he was rhyming and we was rhyming. We always used to, we started off doing shows together before we were signed. We always said if we ever get on, that we was going to stay together. So now we're here together. It feels great.
All right. Well, you all definitely have moved on to bigger and better things.
Definitely.
Congratulations.
No doubt.
I'm going to stay here and chat with Jadakiss for a while. Take a look at Scott.